And as Kratos approached the temple, it became clear that the task ahead was more than he could have ever imagined. Once again, the strange, lingering melody could be heard through the black fog of Morpheus, haunting Kratos. Kratos stood was the sun chariot of Helios, the very chariot that the fire steeds pulled across the sky every day, allowing the brilliance of Helios to shine down on all mankind.
Kratos.
Athena, what madness has befallen us?
Kratos, there is not much time. Olympus needs you.
I grow tired of the gods' request, Athena. I have given enough. Now take these nightmares from my head!
It is not for you to say when your servitude ends. You will earn your freedom in time. But for now, Olympus needs your unquestioning obedience. The god of the sun has been torn from the sky. This temple on which you stand is the chariot of Helios. Without their master to reign them, the fire steeds have driven the sun chariot into the earth. And without Helios, there is no one to keep Morpheus from seizing permanent power. Many of the gods have fallen into a deep slumber. Soon, all will succumb to the black grip of Morpheus.
What would you have me do?
You must find Helios and return him to the sky. Lest the world of gods and men be lost forever. Only his light can release the grasp of Morpheus.
Athena! Athena!
Yeah. I am grateful you have come, Ghost of Sparta. The Titan Atlas has been freed from the pits of Tartarus and has taken my brother Helios from his rightful place in the sky.
What does Atlas want with the Sun God?
Helios holds within him the power of the sun, a power so great it can destroy the world. It cannot be trusted in the hands of a Titan. Please, take the sun shield from his throne, walk through the gates of Olympus, and you will find me. Hurry, Kratos. Even now, my brother suffers at the hand of Atlas.